Did you know that the average Microsoft Enterprise agreement includes unused software that amounts to between 20 and 40% of the value of the contract? With companies investing hundreds of thousands and millions of dollars in these contracts, you'd expect them to be negotiated to the exact requirements of the company. However, with most organizations lacking important information and the reality that Microsoft is the king of the bundle, negotiating these contracts can feel like a tiresome game of cat and mouse as you juggle license bundles. E3 versus E5, anyone? Contract types, EA, SE, MPSA, and confusing licensing terms as you try and optimize your Microsoft licensing spend. So in this video, we'll show you 5 incredibly simple Microsoft licensing hacks you can apply to your negotiations with Microsoft to avoid purchasing unneeded licenses, decrease your cost, and save you a ton of time and aggravation. Number 1, understand your deployments. Visualizing and understanding your deployment data is one of the most important components to negotiating with Microsoft. Unfortunately, though, it can also be one of the most frustrating things you should do when preparing for your enterprise agreement renewal. With multiple data sources, rows and rows of data that need to be stitched together, and often IT departments that are unaware of all the data that is required. A great way to understand your deployment data is utilize a simple data visualization and inventory normalization tool, such as SAM Compass. This tool works with your inventory tools, SCCM, Alteryx, Flexera, etc., to easily bring the data you need together in a simple workable format so you can easily apply software licenses to your deployments in the most optimal manner. Number 2, deconstruct Microsoft's bundles. Microsoft is the king of the bundle. They love to put products together in a single part number and offer perceived steep discounts that save you money. However, the reality is these bundles contribute to the large overspend on Microsoft contracts. To avoid overpaying for the bundle, you need to analyze your deployment and usage data to understand what you truly need. You can look at different ways to purchase licenses, such as a la carte. Don't be afraid to break the bundle or consider moving outside of the EA for your licensing needs to save yourself money. Number 3, motivate your account team. So often negotiations are thought of as us against them. With Microsoft, you want to think about it differently. Try and figure out ways to get your Microsoft account team working for you. Are you looking at trying a new Microsoft service? Deploying something to the cloud? Work with the team on a pilot for Azure. This doesn't mean you need to purchase this new service, but if you can focus your account team on things they want, they are much more likely to negotiate on your behalf for things that you want. Number 4, understand what win means. Microsoft wants to win the negotiation. There are no ifs, ands, or buts about it. However, win means different things to different people at Microsoft, and your only true leverage is to understand this. Your account rep wins by selling you more and exceeding their quota. This obviously goes against your desire to decrease your costs. A district vice president, however, may see a win as a new deployment of a strategic product like Azure. Guess who has more power? You got it, the VP. Learning to speak that VP's language and discussing things other than revenue could point to a win for you in the form of some major savings. Number 5, hire experts. If you've spent any time trying to understand all the nuances of Microsoft licensing, you know how complicated it is. In fact, over the 3-year term of your Microsoft Enterprise Agreement, Microsoft will make almost 500 changes to their licensing programs and product use rights. If your full-time job isn't Microsoft licensing, how do you stay on top of all these changes? Let alone understand which changes will cost you more money, how they impact what you are doing with your licenses, or if you will need to figure out new ways to count. There are experts out there like Method180 who all they do is negotiate licensing contracts with Microsoft on behalf of customers just like you. If you'd like help to drive unnecessary licenses and cost out of your enterprise agreement with Microsoft, get in touch via the link below or email us at info@method180.com. We'd love to help you out.